Hi students, welcome back to Cloud Shiksha 365. In continuation to AWS administration basic course that we are doing now. In previous chapter, we discussed about how to create a new account and how to log in. Now, before we get started with various services, I just want to show you a bit about the user management. So once you have set up your new account, you have a root user and root password to get into your AWS console, AWS management console, but do not start directly with root. It's not recommended that you start with root. So always it's good to have a non-root user. And that will help you to secure your account. And also, we can do that using the creating a non-root user. So now, let me just bring here. This is once we are logged in, we are here. As per my previous chapter also, we saw and we preferred, we marked EC2 as our preferred service. So let's go back to services and here. If we go little down, you will see here security, identity and compliance. So I will click on this and then here we will go to IAM. So I will mark IAM as our preferred one because we will keep going here and here under this this service section. So now you will see here the first thing it is saying security recommendation. Add MFA to root user, which is really very important. We should definitely use MFA. I will do it maybe in a second step, but first of all, let's create one user and let's create a user called, I will say it CS user, CS365 user, I'll call it. Next. Add user to group. So this is important. Now we should definitely use a group, and if we do not have any group, just rather create a group, because having groups are always good. So I will make here CS365 admin. I'm calling it CS365 admin group. Under this group, what kind of policies you want to attach? So maybe policies we will cover later also, but like for now, you can see here administrator access policy is there. Then AWS Elasticloud service, for now let's say I'm just keeping it administrator access policy, and then create this user group. So now user is created, we select this and then we go next. Now it is showing here that this is the permission summary where this group will be a part of our new user. So I will just click on create user. And you see here CS365 user is now being created, and later we will log in with this user just to make sure that we are not creating any harmful actions, and it's always under restrictions, which is a good practice. So it will take a while and then this user will be created. So within user, if we just open this user, you see the summary, and little below, if we go to security credentials, it is saying enable console access. So still console access is not enabled. We now click on enable console access, and then we set up some password here, or sometime it is also auto generated password. User must create new password at next sign. This is how it is. Otherwise we can use always a custom password. So I'm just creating a custom password for now. And then you can also mark user must create new password at next time, so that you know how it behaves. And now this is the console that we will be using. I copied it, I close it. I will log out my session because we have to log in now in my another session here. So I will open new incognito window. I will paste this console URL that we have created. So now here is the ID, and now here we have CS365 user and then the password. And I log in. You see, we have checked that user must change his password at first login attempt. So this is what it is asking for. So first, now the password that we have provided, that we have to enter here, and then the new password. Confirm password, and there we go. So you see here now I'm logged in here as this user. Still, since admin, the group that we created has admin rights, so that's why I'm able to get into EC2 dashboard. I can even create instances here. So that is something now we will be doing next. So the first step always is, once you have access to your management console, create a non-root user and do everything using that particular user. So subscribe, like, and hit bell icon to my channel. Thank you.